Today I am explaining 4th chapter quadratic equations in that exercise 4.2. First question is find the roots of the following quadratic equations by factorization. First question is x square minus 3x minus 10 is equal to 0. Here multiply the quotient of x square is 1, multiply 1 into here minus 10, here constant is minus 10. 1 into minus 10 is equal to minus 10. Now write the factors of 10. That is, factors of 10 is 5 into 2. 5 and 2 are factors of 10. But here 5 into 2 we are getting plus 10. But here we need minus 10. So here keep minus 5 into 2. Okay. Add this minus 5 plus 2. How much will get? Minus 3. That here we are getting that minus 3. So here write x square minus 5x plus 2x minus 10 is equal to 0. Now from this 2, take x as common. X here 1x will be minus and here 5. Here take plus 2 as common. Here x is the remaining one. 2 into x, 2x. And 2 into 5 you will get 10. So here write minus 5. 2 5s. So, x plus 2 and x minus 5 is equal to 0 is equal to 0. So, factors are x plus 2 is equal to 0. From this, x is equal to minus 2 and x minus 5 is equal to 0. From this, x is equal to transport minus 5 to right side, it will become plus 5. So, roots of the following quadratic, roots of x square minus 3x minus 10 is equal to 0 or minus 2 comma 5. That's it. Second question is 2x square plus x minus 6 is equal to 0. Now multiply the quotient of x square is 2 and constant is minus 6, that is minus 12. Now write the factors of minus 12, that is 4 into 3. But in the answer we need minus. So take here 4 into minus 3. Why I am taking minus 3 here? 4 plus minus 3 is equal to 1. Here we need plus 1. That's why I am writing minus for smaller number. Okay. So 2x square plus 4x minus 3x minus 6 is equal to 0. So here take 2x as common. Here it will become x plus 2 and here take minus 3 common. Here 3 into x, 3x minus I am taking outside, that's why here I'll get plus. 3 to 6 plus 2 is equal to 0. So 2x minus 3 and x plus 2 into x plus 2 is equal to 0. Now 2x minus 3 to find the factors, 2x minus 3 is equal to 0 and r x plus 2 is equal to 0. 2x minus 3, 2 transport minus 3 to left right side, it will become plus 3. Now x is equal to transport this 2 to right side, it will become 3 by 2. Or here x transport plus 2 to right side, it will become minus 2. So roots of 2x square plus x minus 6 is equal to 0 or 3 by 2 comma minus 2. Question, third question is root of 2x square plus 7x plus 5 root 2 is equal to 0. Now here quotient of x square is root 2. Here I'll write root 2 into constant is 5 root 2. So root 2 is 2. 5 into 2, that is equal to 10. So here factors of 10 are 5 and 2. Plus 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. Here we are getting. So write this as root 2 x square plus 5 x plus 2 x plus 5 root 2 is equal to 0. So here take x as common. Root 2 x will get plus 5. Only we are taking x outside. Here also take 2 outside here, so it will become root 2x. Here we are taking 2 out, root 2, take root 2 outside. So here root 2 into root 2, 2. Here we will get 2. Root 2 into root 2 is 2. So I am taking root 2 as common. Here I am writing root 2x plus here root 2 I have taken common. So only 5 will be the remaining one. It's equal to 0. So x plus root 2 into root 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. So x plus root 2 is equal to 0. From this x is equal to transpose plus root 2 to right side, it will become minus root 2. And root 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. Root 2x transpose plus 5 to right side, it will become minus 5. So x is equal to transpose this root 2 to right side, it will become minus 5 by root 2. So rationalize this one, multiply numerator and denominator with root 2, root 2, root 2. So minus 5 root 2, root 2 into root 2 is 2. So this is the answer. Roots of root 2 x square plus 7x plus 5 root 2 is equal to 0 are, first one is minus root 2, second one is minus 5 root 2 by 2. That's it. Fourth question is 2x square minus x plus 1 by 8 is equal to 0. Now I'll take this one as LCM. 8. 2x square into 8. 2 here, I'll get 2x square into 8 minus x into 8 plus 1 is equal to 0. So 8 to 16x square minus 8x plus 1 is equal to, transport this 8 to right side, it will become 0 into 8 is equal to 0. So here it equation will be 16x square minus 8x plus 1 is equal to 0. Now multiply x square, coefficient of x square with the constant, that is 16 into 1 is equal to 16. That's it. Now write the factors of 16. That is 4 into 4. 4 into 4, 4 plus 4 is 8. But here we need minus 8. But and the answer, in if we multiply that, we have to get plus 16. So here keep minus 4. Here also keep minus 4. Minus 4 into minus 4 is plus 16. So here write 16x square minus 4x minus 4x plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay. 16x square. Now take 4x as common. 4 fours 16. 4x here. 4x into 1 minus 4 here minus I am keeping. 4x into 1 4x. Now take minus 4x. Minus 1 as common. Here it will become 4x minus 1 is equal to 0. So 4x minus 1 into 4x, this one 4x minus 1 I am writing separately, and this I am writing separately. 4x minus 1 is equal to 0. So 4x minus 1 is equal to 0. 4x is equal to transport this minus 1 to right side, it will become 1. From this x is equal to transport this 4 to right side, x is equal to 1 by 4. Here also 4x minus 1 is equal to 0. From that we will get x is equal to 1 by 4. So roots of 2x square minus x plus 1 by 8 is equal to 0 or 1 by 4 comma 1 by 4. Next fifth one is 100x square minus 20x plus 1. Now multiply coefficient of x square is 100 into constant is 1. 100 into 1, 100. Factors of 100, I'll take 10 into 10. 10 plus 10 here, you'll get 20. But here we need minus 20. So here instead of 10 into 10, I'll write minus 10 into minus 10. Minus 10 minus 10 is equal to minus 20. So 100 x square minus 10x minus 10x plus 1 is equal to 0. So take 10 as common. Here 10x as common. So here 10x, 10 into 10, 100. X into x, x square minus 1. Here take minus 1 as common. It will become 10x minus 1 is equal to 0. So from this 10x minus 1 take common. 10x minus 1. Here remaining 10x minus 1 is equal to 0. So 10x minus 1 is equal to 0. Transport this one to right side. It will become plus 1. From this x is equal to transport this 10 to right side 1 by 10. So this is the first root. And second root also you will get same 10x minus 1 is equal to 0. From that x is equal to 1 by 10. So roots of 100x square minus 20x plus 1 is equal to 0 are 1 by 10 comma 1 by 10. Second question is, solve the problems given in example 1. In that, here they have given this problems in the example 1. X square minus 45x plus 324 is equal to 0. And second one, x square minus 55x plus 750 is equal to 0. Let's solve first one. X square, here coefficient of x square is 1. And constant term is 324. That is equal to 1 into 324 is equal to 324. Here, I'll write factors of this one. 9 into 36 I'll take. 9 into 36 is equal to 324. 9 plus 36 is equal to 45. But in the answer, we need minus 45. So, I'll keep minus 9 into minus 36. Minus into minus plus. 9 into 36, 324 you'll get. So, here, write this one as x square minus 9x minus 36x plus 324 is equal to 0. Okay. So, here take x as common. X minus, here we have taken x, remaining will be 9. Here take minus 36 as common. Here x, 36 into 9, 324. So, x minus 9 is equal to 0. Take x minus 9 common. Remaining will be x minus 36 is equal to 0. So, x minus 9 is equal to 0. Transport minus 9 to right side. It will become plus 9. X is equal to 9. And x minus 36 is equal to 0. Transport minus 36 to right side. It will become plus 36. So, roots of x square minus 45x plus 324 is equal to 0 or 9 comma 36. That's it. In the second question is x square minus 55x plus 750. Now multiply the quotient of x square is here 1 and constant is 750. You will get 750. 25 3 is 75. So, I will take 25 into 30. I will write. Okay, 25 into 30 is 750. But here, we need minus 55. But if you multiply this minus 20, so I will write minus 25 minus 30. Minus into minus plus 25 into 30 plus 750. You will get. So, x square, write this one minus 25x minus 30x plus 750 is equal to 0. So, x take common, x minus 25. Here, minus 30 take common, x minus 25 here. Why here we are getting minus? Minus into minus plus. So, 30 into 25 is 750. So, minus 25 we are getting here. Is equal to 0. So, x minus 25 into x minus 30 is equal to 0. So, now x minus 25 is equal to 0. That is transport minus 25 to right side. It will become plus 25. Now x minus 30 is equal to 0. Transport minus 30 to right side. It will become plus 30. So roots of x square minus 55x plus 750 is equal to 0 or 25 comma 30. That's it. Third question is find the two numbers whose sum is 27 and the product is 182. Let the two numbers are x comma y. Okay, so here sum is x plus y is 27. So from this x is equal to 27 minus, sorry, y is equal to 27 minus x. Okay, one number is x, another number y is 27 minus x. So sum, now product is 182. They have given x into y is equal to 182. They have given here x into y is 27 minus x is equal to 182. Sorry. So x into 27, 27x minus here minus we have minus x into x, x square is equal to 182. So 27x minus x square transport this 182 to left side, it will become minus 182 is equal to 0. So I'll take minus common from all this. Here it will become minus 27x. Here minus I'm taking outside, that's why it will become plus x square. Here minus I'm taking outside, so minus will become plus 182 is equal to 0. So x square, first I'll write x square minus 27x plus 182 is equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation. Let's solve the quadratic equation. Now multiply the quotient of x square is 1, and here I'll write 1, and constant is 182. 1 into 182 is 182. Now I'll write factors of 182. 13 into 14 is 182. Plus 13 plus 14 is 27. But in the answer we need minus 27. Minus 27. So here keep minus 13, minus 14. Minus 13 minus into minus plus 13 into 14, 182. So you'll get same. So x square minus 13x minus 14x plus 182 is equal to 0. Here take x as common, it will become x minus 13 minus, here 14 take common, it will become x minus 14 into 13, 182 is equal to 0. Here minus into minus plus. So take x minus 13 common, here this one is x minus 14 is equal to 0. So x minus 13 is equal to 0. From that you'll get x is equal to 13. Here x is equal to 13, but y is equal to 27 minus x. Y is equal to 27 minus x, that is equal to 27 minus 13 is equal to 14. Okay, in second case x minus 14 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 14, but y is equal to 27 minus x, that is 27 minus 14 is equal to 13. So roots of two numbers are, x is equal to 13, y is equal to 14, are x is equal to 14, y is equal to 13. Fourth question is find two consecutive positive integers sum of whose squares is 365. Here let the two consecutive positive integers are x comma x plus 1. In the question what they have given, sum of two squares of two consecutive integers is equal to 365. So here first one is x square, second one is x plus 1 whole square, okay, is equal to 365. X square write as it is, plus x plus 1 whole square is in the form of a plus b whole square. That is x square a square plus b square plus. Here I'll write a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So here x square b is 1. So 1 square plus 2 into x into 1 is equal to 365. X square, here x square plus x square, that is 2x square plus 1, 2 into x into 1 is 2x, is equal to 365. Here 2x square plus 2x plus 1, transport plus 365 to left side, it will become minus 365, is equal to 0. So divide, 2x square plus 2x, here plus 1 minus 365 is minus 364, is equal to 0. So divide this, here we have this equation with 2. Divide the equation with 2. Okay. So 2x square by 2 plus 2x by 2 minus 364 by 2 is equal to 0. So 2 will get cancelled here, 2 will get cancelled here, 2 ones, 2 eights, 2 twos. So x square plus x minus 182 is equal to 0. Now multiply, the quotient of x square is 1 and constant is minus 182 is equal to 1 into minus 182 is minus 182. 182 factors are 13 and 14. But here we need minus 182. So keep here minus 13 into 14. Minus 13 plus 14 is plus 1 here. Okay. So x square minus 13x plus 14x minus 182 is equal to 0. So take x as common, x minus 13 you will get, plus 14 as common, here also you will get x minus 13 is equal to 0. So x plus 14 into x minus 13 is equal to 0. So x is equal to, x plus 14 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 14. But here they told two consecutive positive integers. Here we got minus 14. So don't consider this one. Next one, x minus 13 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 13. So take this as the integer, positive integer. So x is 13. So x plus 1 is 13 plus 1 is equal to 14. So 2 consecutive positive integers are 13, gamma, 14. That's it. Fifth question is, the altitude of a right angle triangle is 7 cm less than its base. If the hypotenuse is 13 cm, find the other two sides. This is the right angle triangle. This is base. This is altitude. AB, C I'll take. Here AB is base and AC is altitude. AB, so let's take AB is equal to base is equal to x. Okay. Here this altitude is AC, that is equal to, here 7 centimeters less than its base. So 7 centimeters less than its base. X minus, it will become x minus. So according to Pythagoras theorem, here they have given other information also. Hypotenuse, this one, hypotenuse is 13 centimeters. Hypotenuse, that is equal to BC is equal to 13 centimeters they have given. Okay, according to Pythagoras theorem, BC square is equal to AC square plus AB square. BC is 13 square. AC square is x minus 7 whole square plus AB is x square. So here this is in the form of A minus B whole square. I'll write this one left side and this one right side. Okay, x square plus 7 square minus 2 into x into 7 plus x square is equal to 13. 13 square is 13 into 13, that is 169. Okay, here x square, here x square, that is 2x square plus 7 square, 7 7 is 49, 2 7 is 14 minus 14x is equal to 169. So 2x square minus 14x plus 49 minus 169. Transport this 169 to left side, it will become minus 169. So 2x square minus 14x plus 49 minus 169, that is minus 120 is equal to 0. Divide this equation with 2. Divide this equation with 2. So 2x square by 2 minus 14x by 2 minus 120 by 2 is equal to 0. 2 ones, 2 sevens 14, 2 ones, 2 ones will get cancelled, 2 ones, 260s. So x square minus 7x minus 60 is equal to 0. Here now multiply quotient of x square and constant, that is 1 into minus 60 is equal to minus 60. Now write factors of 60, that is 12 is 60, but we need minus 60. So write minus 12. Minus 12 in plus 5 is equal to minus 7. Minus 12 plus 5 is equal to minus 7. So here write x square minus 12x plus 5x minus 60 is equal to 0. So take x as common, x minus 12. Here take plus 5 as common. Here also it will become x minus 12 is equal to 0. Now x minus 12 take outside and x plus 5. Okay, is equal to 0. Here x minus 12 is equal to 0. Okay, here from this x is equal to 12 centimeters. This is the base. Base is equal to 12 centimeters and altitude. Altitude is equal to x minus 7. That is 12 minus 7. That is equal to 5 centimeters. In this is first case, in x plus 5 is equal to 0. Now x plus 5 is equal to 0. Here x is equal to minus 5. Base cannot be negative and altitude also cannot be negative. So this, so don't take this one into consideration. Only from this, base is equal to 12 centimeters and altitude is equal to is equal to 5 centimeters. This is the answer. Sixth question is, a cottage industry produces a certain number of pottery articles in a day. It was observed on a particular day that the cost of production of each article was 3 more than twice the number of articles produced on that day. If the total cost of the production on that day was 90, find the number of articles produced and the cost of each article. Here let's take number of articles is equal to x. Let's take number of articles is equal to x. So cost of, here they have given cost of production of each article, cost of production of each article is equal to 3 more than twice the, twice means 2 times the number of articles. Number of articles are x. This means 3 plus 2x. Next, total cost of production on that day was 90. So total cost of production is equal to rupees 90, they have given this one. But how you will get total cost of production, number of articles into cost of production of each article. You will get total cost of production. So, x into 3 plus 2x is equal to 90. X into 3, 3x. X into 2x plus here plus we have 2x square. Here transport plus 90 to left side, it will become minus 90 is equal to 0. So, 2x square plus 3x minus 90 is equal to 0. Here, multiply the quotient of x square and constant. 2 into minus 90, that is equal to minus 180. Factors of 180 are 12 into 15. 15 twos 30, 15 ones 15, 180. So, here minus, but we need minus 180 in the answer. So, I will take minus 12 plus 15. Plus 15 minus 12 will get plus 3. Here we have plus 3. So, write 2x square plus 15x minus 12x minus 90 is equal to 0. So, take, now write 2x square minus 12x. Here we can take common from this 2. We can take 2 common from this 2 numbers. That's why I am writing. Plus 15x. 15x minus 90 is equal to 0. So, take 2x common. Here you will get x minus 6. 2 into 6, 12. So, minus 6. Here take plus 15 common. 15, 6 is 90. So, here also you will get x minus 6. Take x minus 6 outside. Here write 2x plus 15 is equal to 0. So, first x minus 6 is equal to 0. From this, x is equal to 6. And 2x plus 15 is equal to 0. 2x is equal to minus 15. So, x is equal to minus 15 by 2. Number cannot be negative. Number of articles cannot be negative. So, here I will take this one, x is equal to 6 into consideration. So, number of articles produced in a day or in the day. Number of articles produced is equal to 6, and cost of 6 articles is equal to 3 plus 2x, that is 3 plus 2 into x is here 6. So, 3 plus 2, 6, 12, 15. So, cost of 6 articles is equal to rupees 15. Cost of 6 articles is equal to rupees 15. That's it.